I just got him laying in the street dead as just got him laying.
I'm in denial, and it don't take no x-ray to see right through my smile. I know I'll be on the go, and it ain't no drink out there that can numb my soul. Oh no. All we wanna do is take the chains off. All we wanna do is break the chains off, man. All we wanna do is be free. All we wanna do is be free. All we wanna do is take the chains off. All we wanna do is break the chains off, man. All we wanna do is be free.
How you gonna stop it when it's happening simultaneously around the world, not just in St. Louis? We in Chicago doing the same thing.
Every time I step outside, I see my niggas down.
It ain't gonna stop. We not gonna let them stop us. We not gonna let it go back to the status quo. We ain't gonna start killing our kids. They can't go to the store and make it home because of motherfuckers. Because of this. Because of a sin, God. You know, you gonna kill our kids? You crazy? Who's gonna stand for that? You know, if that was a white boy, what would have happened to us? They'd have hung us from the high street. And y'all ain't forgot the Gen of Six that they accused them, and them boys hadn't done nothing?
Right.
Y'all don't remember them? That's what's up. That's what they do to us. They lynch us for nothing. And like they just lynched our boy, Mike Brown. That's why I am Mike Brown.
That's right.
This is literally the real deal. But people, it's kind of in a shock. They're in shock because they are not believing that that's what's really finna go down.
At no time the officer said that he was gonna do anything until he pulled out his weapon. His weapon was drawn and he said, "I'll shoot you, or I'm going to shoot." And in the same moment, the first shot went off. And we looked at him. He was shot, and it was blood coming from him. And we took off running. Are we all alone, fighting on our own? Please give me a chance. I don't wanna dance. Something's got me down. I will stand my ground. Don't just
stand around. Don't just stand around.
As we took off running, I ducked and hid for my life because I was fearing for my life. And I hid by the first car that I saw. My friend, he kept running. And he told me to keep running because he feared for me too. So as he was running, the officer was trying to get out of the car. And once he got out the car, he pursued my friend, but his weapon was drawn. Now, he didn't see any weapon drawn at him or anything like that. Us going for no weapon. His weapon was already drawn when he got out the car.
How the march went, how much unity we had out there. We need to look at all the love that we're feeding off. Even though some people unrighteous agenda,
right?
Because you know, as a speaker that spoke up there, I felt like you rushing something. You know what I'm saying? You're not really listening to the voice of the community. I am part of the community. I am part of the residents around me. Therefore, I knew my mic, you know what I'm saying? But the part that we need to really look at is how we're gonna come together again and again and again to try to stop it. We need to cut the head off so the body can fall. You know what I'm saying? We need to get out there and this to everybody. To everybody. You hear me? Voting can help. You gotta know your part. You gotta know exactly what your part is to do, to remove something out of your perimeter. You have to know how to move it. You have to know how to lift. You know how they teach you how to lift up things so you won't hurt your back. You gotta be able to remove this situation in a way political. You gotta know your political rights. You gotta know your law. You know what I'm saying? Mike didn't have the right. He didn't have, his rights was taken away from him. You know what I'm saying? He didn't have no rights no more. After that cop shot him the last 5-6 times, it was over. His rights was taken away from him. So to everybody, you know, today, and the first day it happened, you've seen unity come together. You've seen love. Family love. Not even though these people ain't in your family, we was family up. You know, we shut down some places that we need to shut down today. But when it first started, we let a lot of our voices be heard. You know what I'm saying? But on a lot of things, the police is still around. They still disrespecting us. They still showing up when they ain't supposed to be showing up.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So right now we need to cut the head off so the body can fall. That means we got to get rid of not just Ferguson police. Right. One, they need to change the whole thing.
Yeah.
They need to check. They need to really move everybody that was in that department out. Bring county in to take over. Now what they trying to do is they trying to take a black cop and a white cop and put them in the car together.
Right.
You're just putting what you're doing is you're taking the cover and putting it over somebody's head.
Exactly.
Like you can't see you. You know what I'm saying? So in our way, we already see what you're doing. You know what I'm saying? You could blindfold a person,
right?
But the fact is, the problem is still there.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So
exactly.
You're not doing nothing to help us.
Right, yeah.
What you're doing is you're trying to intimidate us.
Right, right.
Trying to make it seem like we're dumb.
Yeah, right.
We're not dumb. Ferguson, they told us Ferguson was supposed to be relieved from this area. They're not relieved from this area. We've seen them 2-3 times already. They was up and riding up and down here 23 times in one day. How the police do that? What are you trying to do?
Right.
You trying to intimidate the people that's driving up and down here by asking them, or do you live here?
It's ridiculous, man. We're not.
I don't want this to die down. I don't want nobody to think, it's gonna be swept, and everybody, just because one day you see nobody, it takes leading to bring everybody together. But don't let all the cameras. That's because the TV cameras are here and CNN and CBS and see, when they gone, we still protesting. All that, you know what I'm saying?
Not just young men, African American men, but just African Americans, period, have been by the hands of police officers and police brutality, have been slain, you know, and giving us an image of terror in our communities that is really designed to just strike terror within and division, which already exists. But what I want to speak on is about what we're facing here, and it's just not a Mike Brown thing. It's something that's going on from place to place, city to city, wherever we are. We have a situation where we have white municipalities governing over our communities, which are African American, and it takes it back to a situation that resemblance of the plantation. And so when we look at those dynamics, there is something that's brewing. If you keep a person down or people down for so long, there's some events or some things that are going to happen that are tragic, but those are the things that are just going to mount up and mount up and mount up until one day it's just going to explode, which I think happened here in Ferguson, is that what you see, the QT being burned down and the rioting and some of the looting and all that stuff. There are some other things that, underlying things that are involved with that, but that's what happened when a community says enough is enough. So this is what my concern here is, that as you go across the country and it continues to happen, that, you know, people will look at Ferguson and say, well, you know what, just like Ferguson, we're not going to take this. So, and what begins to happen then is we become to be at war in our own communities. So what we're trying to do is to try and come together and to see a more peaceful resolve, if there is one. I do believe that there is a time for war and there's a time for peace, but for at least if we can come together and see what time we're in and what's needed within our communities. As you can see, this community here is resemblance of the projects. Don't be mistaken by how it looks, but it's the same type of situation where the community is have the same dynamics, low income, and then not access to any of the resources that are needed to sustain a healthy living. So you put that into a situation, pressurized situation, where these young children, even through this Ferguson situation, where the children were out of school, and at night they were had to smell tear gas while they were going to bed, and they were going hungry, even going to bed. So that's terror on our young people. So what we want to do is as a people, to come together, young folk, old folks, whatever, to come together and to come to a resolve on about how we live and how we are able to survive, or how we're going to be able to survive. And so that's been my concern and my voice about what we need to do. It's not a time to be divided. It's a time to come together. My grandparents told me about the unity that they had all along when they were in the South and they came North. That's what needs to happen here, is we need to not forget about our unity that we have, to come together and to look out for one another, and to have a place that we can live in peace, with where we patrol our own neighborhoods and where we teach our own children in our community about our African American history and our African history and our roots, because no one else is going to patrol us like we can do our own, and no one else is going to educate our young the way we can do our own.
If I knew I was gonna be speaking, man, I would've wore my Sunday best.
That's all right, man. That's all right. We want them to see y'all just like how you are, young people. Uh-huh. You know, right now there's a lot of people in summer coming in and out. We don't have any people that we have, but at least to get the message out to show what you all are doing. You know, you all have impressed me with how far you come and what you're in your heart of it. So I, you know, whoever's here meant for.
Right.
So. You guys can come on in. If you guys wanted to keep your car where you at,
yeah, it's fine.
It's safe. You know, there we got the same security guy had at first. Right. Then we found out that the sheriff department had came in and made it this church. Right. So we said, you know what? We're further away from Ferguson.
Right.
And we're going to be here. We're going to take up that from this church. Right. The police have come to kill us and take it from them. We're going to try and be a relief so that, you know, maybe a little further off, but we're going to take it from the bank. Because they hit this church kind of really strategically, you know, in war, you know, you hit the spot.
Right.
It cripples
right.
The army.
Right.
And so that's what they did. They didn't have to go over that experience.
Right.
You know, so I'm going to show you a little bit of, you know, awareness that you all bring, spirit that you bring. I say, okay, if here, clearly, if these three young men can come from North Carolina.
Right.
All the way across, halfway across the country.
Right.
We right here in St. Louis.
Right.
You
right.
know, let's do this. Right. You know. So, again, man, I'm very impressed. Glad you guys came.
Yeah, I'm glad.
Go to. It's where we are housed. Purple, I think. Just because you got this room was kind of cool. The diapers and all that kind of stuff. But this is kind of what we have left. Take down. This is a collection of other churches, and like I said, we had some more, but this the last couple weeks been taken out. The other I have not hit or tapped into the other three churches
right.
so far. So that's what I'm looking to do this week is to say, okay, if we've gotten down, they give us a chance to replenish while I go and
work
for those other churches and then come back this way and
right,
then
right,
give them
right.
a chance
right.
to replenish. But you know, whatever donation that you'll have, it will come here and be ready to get put out, you know, or whatever, and so that your people know that their contribution, because that's all I'm really, we're really doing too, is taking some and we're giving it to the people who are distributing,
right, right,
you know,
right.
supplying them, and then you, what basically what you are doing will be tapping into that,
right,
you know. So again, man, give me your names again.
Cameron Moon, David Williams, and William Green.
William Green, okay.
All right.
The past remind us of things that bridges that we felt like we've already crossed, but in reality it doesn't seem like we've really crossed
right.
the bridges.
Right. Right.
And so
I can't sit in front of the TV and watch and keep watching what's happening to our brothers and sisters and not do anything about it.
Amen.
I'm not gonna say anything in my testimony, but I'll just tell you that it affected me. To see it happen over and over again.
Yes.
And you know, I've spoken to community leaders and pastors in Charlotte, North Carolina, and they feel the same way. We had rallies in Charlotte, we had, you know, there was rallies in Georgia. There was rallies in D.C., there was rallies in New York, and it's coming to a boiling point where we're going to have to stand up and fight for each other.
That's right.
Because nobody's going to fight for
That's
us.
That's right.
The people that we put our trust into, and the only thing that's different between me and Mike Brown is the time and place. I could have been walking down this street, you know. And to see, you know, CNN and Fox News and MSNBC tell our story for us,
yeah.
it's not gonna work.
That's right. That's right.
It's not gonna work because they're not gonna tell it how we feel.
That's right.
You know, they don't. They haven't lived. They don't know our story. You know, they're only here for a glimpse,
mm-hmm.
and then they're gone.
That's right.
You know, when it's people still out here suffering, people still out here fighting.
Yes.
You know, so, like I said, we're here to bring light to the situation. And, you know, we're young. We have a conscience. And I think that we're going to keep fighting. I have a younger brother who's 12, and he's confused. you know, it's not because of me, and it's not because of his father. It's just because of what he sees when he walks out that door. You know, like I said, we're not to keep fighting.